I have one question. Sir, whenever I have to express myself, so body is required as an instrument. Without body, I cannot express myself. So, is it right that always a body is required to express myself? Otherwise, I cannot, my expression will not be visible to others. Is it right?
Yeah, it is a very easy way to do it. The most convenient way to do, right? So, if there is one human being,
next slide.
Okay. So, human being one, trying to communicate with another human being. Two. Right. So, if I am doing trying to do this communication, okay, it is very convenient to use the body as an instrument. Okay. But of course, there are possibilities of doing this communication directly at the level of self. Okay. That possibility is there, but we are not really getting into that. Right. What we are saying is that when we are communicating through the body, which is the normal mode of communication between two human beings, then we use the body as an instrument for communication. This communication is done by one self by the other, for the other self, with the other self, and both of them are using the body as an instrument. So, this is one thing. Second is that when you are using the body as an instrument, then what is the process? So, if you look at the process, okay, it looks like this, right? That is, there is a reality, which I am able to see, right? When I am able to see a reality, okay, and I want to communicate to you, right? I will give some name to it, you know, call it by some word, right? So, for example, this is a reality, you know, this pen is a reality, okay? But this name of pen is given by me, right? I am giving this reality a name called pen, right? So, pen is indicating a reality. So, there is a reality which I am able to understand, perceive, conceive, right? And then I am calling it by some name. What I can communicate to you is this word, right? This name. So, when I am saying pen, I am communicating this word to you through my mouth. We are pronouncing this word pen through mouth, right? So, I am taking help of the body to communicate this word pen, right, which is the name of a reality, right? Is that clear? Okay. So, when I am doing that, so human being sees a reality, gives a name to it. Right. What I am communicating is this word, right? So, this word is communicated. What the other person is getting a word, right? Right. And from there he is trying to conclude about the reality, right? Reality dash. This reality may be same as the reality which was communicated, or it may be different, right? When it is the same reality, the communication has taken place. When it is a different reality, then there is a miscommunication. So, in the normal mode, So if this R prime or reality prime is equal to reality, or let us call it reality 1 and reality 2. So, if reality 2 is same as reality 1, communication has taken place, right. So, communication has been successful. If R 2 is not equal to R 1, communication failed, right. So, in the normal transaction, one human being is communicating with another human being through words, through name, through symbols, right. Okay. And for that, using symbol and transmitting symbol, he is using the body as a means. So, this is transaction is taking through body, right. It is seen at the level of self. So, normally yes, the body is used as an instrument for communication, but communication is done by the self for the self, right. Yes.